What is going on, everybody? Today's video is going to be a little bit different. I wanted to talk about a few things because, you know, I was a full-time Mixer streamer, you know, before they shut down, and now I'm a full-time Twitch streamer. So I just really wanted to kind of talk about the things I've noticed, the differences between the two sites. I streamed on Mixer for just over a year, and now I've been on Twitch for just over a year, roughly around the same amount of time on either site. So, you know, my experiences, what I've noticed from one site to the other, what the problems might have been on Mixer and why it went down, to you know, what I think Twitch has that maybe Mixer needed, or the things that Twitch could use that Mixer had. You know, because listen, you got to look at it. There was things that I really liked better on Mixer than that they have on Twitch. And then there's things that I think Twitch does better than Mixer. You know, neither site was perfect. But I'll tell you, let's start off with the first thing. I just think the obvious thing was numbers, right? The obvious thing was numbers. Mixer just didn't have it. And that is one, surprising. And two, it was a shame because Mixer was a very, 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 very good site. You know, I know people are going to be like, what are you talking about, right? It's Mixer, you know, yeah, right, it was Mixer. I get it. It was a very small site. I think that was the big problem. You know, you have streamers like Tim the Tatman. He'll have like 40,000 viewers in a stream at one time. Well, Mixer as an entire site had something like 50,000 concurrent viewers. That's a big problem in a site that, you know, needs numbers and needs that. That's a big part of it. They need people on their site. And that was a big problem. So I think concurrently, I think they had at you know, one point, or I don't know if it was their peak, or, you know, at a certain point, they had like 50,000 concurrent viewers. That is nothing. Like I said, someone like Tim the Tatman might have 40,000 in his stream at one time on Twitch. So the numbers were something like Mixer had 50,000 concurrent viewers. Twitch had something like 3 million. So it doesn't even compare. It doesn't even compete, which is kind of, you know, interesting to me because, you know, Microsoft is what was behind Mixer. They have the money. They have the resources to get themselves out there. They just didn't use them properly. I felt like they really misused the tools they had that really could have got them, you know, maybe not ahead of Twitch, but at least to compete. They were, at the time, I think, the biggest competitor. I know YouTube's up there too. But I think at the time that was their only, maybe a little bit of a competitor, if you even want to call it that. It wasn't really much competition, but that was one of the big, big, big problems. I know another thing they did was, I know I was a partner there. I was a partner on Mixer. You know, Mixer was good. I loved it. It was a really, really, really good site. I was partnered there. So we were part of a Discord that, you know, all the partners were in and stuff, right? I think that was a problem. I think maybe not that was the problem, but I think one of the problems was they let the partners kind of dictate what direction the site goes. And a lot of the partners took advantage of that. What they would do is they wouldn't plug the ideas that were beneficial to the entire site. They would try to push the ideas that benefited them the most. And that's a problem. And when you listen to those partners, that's another problem. So you'd have these certain partners and a little group of them that would try to push the site in a certain direction. And when the high ups kind of listen to that and let this small group kind of dictate how the site runs, that doesn't work that way because it only benefits a few people and it really didn't really help the entire site. And that's a problem. They had a thing where they, you know, people, one of the biggest complaints on Mixer as well was, you know, they only benefited a few partners, right? They'd always push a few partners. I understand, you know, if these partners are good and they're bringing attention to the site, you do want to promote. It's a business. At the end of the day, everything's a business. So I understand that. I understand that part on a business side. You know, if these are the people that are bringing traffic to your site, you need to help them out because they're helping you out. It's one hand washes the other kind of mentality. And I get that. As a business side, I agree with that. Another problem, you know, obviously I'm talking about a lot of problems right now. There was a lot of good things, and I'll get there as well. But I guess, you know, I guess we're on the problems right now, which is easy to really say because there was a lot of problems. But again, there was a lot of really, really, really good things to come from that site as well. So even though I am starting with the problems, I will get to the good stuff. And there was a lot of that as well. One of the, you know, there's so, I think one of the big problems too was, there was not, everybody was a streamer on Mixer. I think that's a big problem too, is there was no, you know, there was viewers, all right, but the majority of people were streamers. So even if you have viewers in your chat. They're just other streamers that are just tabbing you up. We did have a community built in. We were lucky that we were one of the fortunate people that we had a built-in community and people would come back and we had an active chat and all that stuff. But a lot of times, people's chats are just dead because people are just tabbing up for each other to get numbers in their stream. And then, I give you a number, you give me a number. And, it looks like you're doing better than you are, but your chat is completely dead. And that's a problem. It's when everyone's streaming and there's no viewership, that's a problem. Another thing too, which, the partner thing, the ways to get partner was just really backwards there. I like what Twitch does. It makes it harder. It makes it more authentic because on Mixer, I would have my auto host and listen, I'm not going to take anything away from other people too. They helped me the same way. We helped each other. You'd auto host them with, 40 viewers or 50 viewers or 60 viewers or 100 viewers, whatever you had at the time. People would just leave a tab up in your stream because they had, which is actually a good thing, and I'll get there as well. But I'm going to stick to the negatives right now, and then we'll get into the positives. But people would leave tabs up all the time because you could farm things called sparks. Okay. So you'd always have people in your stream farming these things called sparks, and you'd get them by being in streams every so many minutes or something. You get like so many sparks, and then with that you could boost their income and stuff like that, which I'll get into more of that in the positives. But let's stick to kind of our theme that we're going right now. So what happens is people would have all these tabs up and you'd have these auto hosts going. So you would host someone with, say, 60 viewers. But again, there's not a single person sitting there. And for even partnership and stuff, those views counted. So say you needed, a 40 person concurrent viewership, average viewership. If I host you with, 80 viewers and I do that enough times and your average is literally at 70, but you have zero people talking in your chat, you become a partner. And that is backwards. That is horrible because you have these really, talented streamers that, they don't have the numbers. They're good streamers, they're entertainers, but they don't have people like, myself or my friends that were hosting me or, we all helped each other. Okay. But they don't have that connection with these people that could give them those numbers, and they don't make partner. And they have a better channel. They have better a better stream than these so-called partners. And it was horrible. And it was just, I don't like the way they worked that, because all these people that were becoming partners, they weren't great. And that's not a shot at them, but I don't think they deserved it. I don't think they deserved it, to be honest with you. But that, that's a lot of negatives. I want to get more into the positives. I want to get into the positives a little bit. As well. But anyway, another thing they did, I think, they tried by getting Ninja over on Mixer. I think that was a good attempt, okay? But it definitely didn't work the way they expected. And you know what? To be honest, I don't think Ninja's career has really bounced back, stream-wise from that. I know he's killing it with his merchandise and he's got a character in the game Raid, right? Like, he's killing it, okay? And I have no disrespect towards Ninja. I really appreciate the things he's done because of people like that, I'm able to do what I do. And I am a full-time streamer as well now on Twitch. So, because of people like Ninja, I get to do what I do, and I have a lot of respect for that. I'm the kind of guy I always give respect where it's due. If you like the guy or not, that's a different story, but I gotta give the man respect for doing what he did so I can do what I do. But yeah, it definitely didn't go as planned. They spent a lot of money on Ninja. He didn't bring the traffic over that they thought he would. Obviously, at first when he came over, there's a lot of hype, which is great, but that died down really, really quick. And then they brought over Shroud, and I don't know how to say his name, Goliath, King Goliath or something like that. And let me tell you, I haven't had personal one-on-one talks with him, but again, we had the partner Discord, and he was active in there. King Goliath, I don't know how to say his name, but I think that's how you pronounce it. He was very active in there, and he felt like he let, and I have a lot of respect for him, by the way, because he felt like he let us down, and he didn't. He took a lot of, he felt bad. He felt really bad that he couldn't take Mixer to the next level, and it wasn't on him. It's on all of us. It was on all of us, because we're as the streamers and the content creators, we're all there trying to build this site. And you know what? It's not. It doesn't fall on his shoulders. It falls on all of our shoulders. Now, another thing is, Mixer kind of made mistakes, many mistakes along the way. Like simple things, like how Twitch has Twitch Prime. You have Twitch Prime. You can subs for free, and they do things like that. Mixer they have Microsoft, and they couldn't even do that. Like, they're connected to Xbox. You know, if you get an Xbox membership, you know, you buy gold for a month, or you buy gold for whatever, you get a free sub on Mixer. They could have done something just so basic as that, and they didn't. And that's a shame that they didn't do that, because they could have done that, and it's been very easy for them to do that, and they didn't. So, yeah, all they had to do was just say, hey, listen, you get a free month if you get, you know, you go gold for a year or whatever, a month, whatever you want to do it. Hey, you get a free sub on Mixer. So there's a lot of problems like that that they had. So, anyway, I want to get into the positives, because there is a ton of positives, as well. Obviously, it's very easy to talk on the negatives, but there's a ton of positives. One, I love the Spark system. Okay, I talked about it a little bit earlier, where it's like people just had tabs up to farm Sparks, and I thought it was a great. I know we have channel points on Mixer, or sorry, on Twitch, but it's not the same. Okay, these channel points actually help the streamers. So I know how on Twitch the channel points. I don't know exactly what they do, to be honest. So maybe I can't really speak on this, but the Sparks really helped the streamer. It really, really did. So at first, originally, what they used to do was the Sparks would actually be worth currency. So if you had people, like real life money, so if you had people in your stream all the time, or people tabbing up or whatever, you know, whatever, they would accumulate Sparks. And if they spent, you know, a million, if as a community they spent, like, say, 100,000 Sparks, you'd get $50. I don't know what the exact price was. I don't know. But like, say you get up to like 5 million, they spent 5 million Sparks in a month, you could get like $500 or $1,000 or whatever it is. I don't know the exact prices, but it was good. It was good. But that was before my time. So, but that was good. And then when Ninja came over, they switched it to, it still helped, where we had things called Embers. So on Twitch, you have things called Bits. On Mixer, we have things called Embers. And it's the exact same thing. Same currency, one for 1 cent. And, you know, all it's exactly the same. Okay? But these Sparks would multiply how much those Embers or Bits were worth. So at first they had it where it was worth a certain amount of money. And then they said, oh, we can't, I don't know if they can't afford, I don't know what their thought was on it, but they changed it. So now it's like, okay, if you hit a million Sparks in the week, you know, every Ember you made is now worth 10% more. If you hit 10 million Sparks in a week, all your Embers are now worth 30% more. So you literally get a 30% raise from your community dropping those Sparks back into the channel. That is massive for a streamer. That is massive. It's not costing the community any money, and you're getting paid 30% more, or 50 or whatever it was. I think it capped at 30 or 20. I don't remember now, but that's huge. That is huge. Okay. So say a streamer, let's just use a flat number, $1,000. Okay. Say you make $1,000 a month. Okay. And your community puts in that you make 30% more that month. You now made $1,300 just like that. And it didn't cost your community a penny. All they do is leave a tab up on your stream, accumulate Sparks, and throw them your way before the end of the week. And every Ember you made in that week would be multiplied by whatever. Okay, that's amazing. That is a really, really, really cool concept, and I wish something like Twitch had that, because, you know, it is tough to make a full-time living as a streamer. It's not very easy. You don't know what you're going to get from week to week, month to month, and you don't know, and something like that really just helps a little bit. So that was a really, really, really cool idea. Another thing they had was you could put gifts in the chat by using, you know, Sparks or Embers or whatever it was. You could put, you know, a GIF up in the chat, or you could put one thing they actually had that was really, 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 really cool, and it always had a really cool reaction to the stream when it happened. They had things called like Ember Sharks or Ember Dragons or Dumpsters. So if someone came in and put like 1,000 Embers, which is 1,000 bits, in your chat at once, they could trigger, say, a shark to come across your screen. It was really cool. It would be a shark going across your screen eating Embers, but it was like a really cool animation that would just come across your stream. Or if they put like 10,000 Embers, you know, a big dragon would come up or something. You know, it was really, 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 really cool, and it got the chat involved a little bit, and I thought that was really awesome. I loved that. Absolutely loved that. That was really, really, really cool. That's the thing I wish, you know, that Twitch could put in, you know. The biggest thing I would say, the absolute biggest bonus and greatest thing from Mixer, it was something called Faster Than Light, okay? I know to some streamers and some people might think, you know, it's not that big of a deal. We get a 3 to 10 second delay in our chat. But to me, that's very important, okay? That's very, very, very important. Faster Than Light is literally, as I'm saying it, they're hearing it. There is zero delay, 0 seconds. Faster Than Light, instant communication from you to the stream, from the stream to you. They type something, you see it immediately, you respond, they hear it immediately. Now, for someone like me, I'm very chat oriented, very community oriented. So we're always talking with the chat. We're always interacting back and forth. When there's a 20 second delay, you lose a little bit of that momentum. You lose a little bit of that authenticity. It's weird because they asked you something 20 seconds ago, you're responding, and then you're waiting, you know, they see it 20 seconds later, and it's just, the conversation is a little different. But yeah, so that's one thing I really, really, really loved was Faster Than Light. I don't know why Twitch can't do it. I don't know the logistics. I don't know, you know, the back. I don't know all that story. I don't know why. But, the fact that Mixer had it was absolutely incredible. That was one of the greatest things. So people always ask me, another thing people always ask is like, why did you go to Mixer? Why did you start on Mixer? Why not Twitch? I had buddies of mine that have been partnered on Twitch for a very long time. They're like, yo, come over to Twitch, man. What are you doing? You know, Mixer's not it. And you know what? I loved Mixer. I absolutely loved Mixer. To be very honest with you, the community was incredible. Again, Mixer's been shut down for over a year now. I still see the same people. I still see, you know, other streamers and people from our community from Mixer coming through the stream. We were so tight. We built this community. We built these bonds. Everyone kind of knew everybody. It's like that small town feel. And you really built these connections, you know. I feel like one of the problems with Twitch is it's such a big pool with sharks, and you know, it's tough, man, you know. And I do consider myself a good streamer, you know. It's not a flex. I'm not egotistical, but I do feel like we have a good community and we have a very good stream, quality stream. But it's hard. It's very hard to get ahead on Twitch because there's just so many really, really talented and good streamers. And hey, that's awesome. I'm very happy for them. But it's very, very, very hard to get ahead. And, you know, Twitch has been around for a long time. I'm new. I've only been around for about a year on Twitch. But you know, it's very, 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 very tough. Where I felt like on Mixer, you know, and not to give them it's not a shot at any of the streamers there. But again, there was only 50,000 concurrent viewers, and if you're a decent streamer, you could have a lot of those. And we did. We had a very good community built in on Mixer, and you know, it's we had some talent over there. So, but I'll tell you right now, I will tell you one thing. To me, Twitch is the spot. Okay. I want to say that first of all, I think Twitch is the better platform overall. There's a lot of things that could do better. You know, there's Mixer, you know, again, it was a smaller community. It was easier to maintain. I mean, Twitch has so many streamers and viewers. It's a lot harder to kind of, or, you know, have everything set. But, you know, I think Twitch is a spot, you know, and one thing I learned from being on Mixer is these small platforms, they can't compete, okay? They can't compete with Twitch. You know, even when I would meet people, you know, on the street, not on the street, but, you know, you meet people out at, you know, your friend's house or whatever, and they say, oh, what do you do? I say, oh, I'm a full-time streamer or whatever. And they're like, oh, man, you know, what's your Twitch or whatever? And I'm like, oh, no, I'm on Mixer. And they're like, what the fuck is that? Like, what is Mixer? You know? And that's when it's like, you know, it's tough because you're almost... You know, and when people think of streaming, they think of Twitch. They don't think of Mixer. They don't think of Facebook Gaming. They don't think of Trovo. They don't think of Glamesh. You know, that's the truth. I know people don't want to hear it. You know, people that are on Trovo are going to be like, yo, Trovo is the best. I get that. I was like that with Mixer. Mixer all the way. Mixer. I love Mixer, you know. I was the same way. But now that I am on a site like Twitch, you realize that Mixer never had a chance. Like, Mixer never had a chance against this giant. It just didn't. And you realize how much better it is. Now, lucky for us, okay? Now, a lot of streamers, when they left Mixer to go to Twitch, they focused on the wrong things. And I've always had this mentality, and I've always warned people, and I always told people, you can't focus on your numbers. I don't care how many followers I have. I don't care. That doesn't matter to me because that means nothing. Followers mean nothing. I want quality people in my stream. I want a community. That's what I always focus on. I don't care how many followers I have because that means nothing to me, okay? You could have 200,000 followers and 3 people in your stream. That means nothing, okay? So not to say that that's bad, but I'm just saying as a, you know, That's why followers mean nothing, is what I'm trying to say. You have three people in your chat, that's phenomenal. But I'm saying for a numbers, for followers wise, okay? So a lot of people, when they were on Mixer, and I'd tell them, they'd come into my chat, and they'd be like, yo, I just hit, you know, 8,000 followers. It's like, oh, awesome, good for you, man. But, and this is not a shot again, okay? I'm not judging it. It's nothing like this, okay? I'm just sharing the experience. But they had nobody in their stream. So you'd go to their stream, and it's literally, they could stream for 8 hours, and they don't, nothing has been said in their stream. So why do you care that you have 8,000 followers and nobody coming through? To me, that made no sense. I want people to come through. I want people to find the stream, to come into the chat, to get to know me, for me to get to know them, for them to get to know the community, you know, for them to get to know the community, because that's what it's about. And so that was a big problem for a lot of people when Mixer shut down and they had to go to Twitch, is they're like, oh, I have to start over, I have zero followers. Well, who cares? You know, we left Mixer to go to Twitch, we had zero followers too. But guess what? Nothing changed from the community, because we literally left Mixer. We just changed from going from mixer.com/CaponeGaming. It was now twitch.tv/CaponeGaming. The very next day, we had the same people that were on Mixer, our exact community, come over to Twitch. And it's like nothing changed. Nothing changed. We still had the same viewership. We still had the same people. And as a matter of fact, we had a lot more people coming in, because now there was a bigger pool to get noticed in. And it was awesome. It was absolutely incredible. So that was a big problem for a lot of people, is they focused on the wrong things. And I would, and some of, you know, some of your friends, you got to be honest, and you got to say, listen, man, don't worry about that stuff. Don't worry about the followers. That stuff will come. Focus on community. And as soon as they had to make that switch, they're like, I can't stream anymore. I'm done. I'm shutting it down, because they don't have those numbers that they thought was very important, which is just empty numbers. That was a big, big thing. And it's too bad, man, because you see a lot of these Mixer streamers that just, they gave up. You know, and that's the way it is. Now, let me tell you something. I'll get into a little bit on Facebook gaming as well. So when we left, or not, we didn't leave Mixer, when Mixer kind of closed the doors on us. And by the way, we found out Mixer was closing the doors by a tweet. Nobody told us. Okay, this is a true story. I found out that I was out of a job. That was my job. Mixer was my job. I found out that I didn't have a platform anymore over Twitter. They didn't tell me. They put a tweet out there. And you know how I found out? People were retweeting it and stuff. I was like, what's going on here, man? What do you mean Mixer's shutting down? Nobody said anything. And even in our Discord chat, they didn't tell us. They didn't give us a heads up. We found out the same time as the entire world did, which is a slap in the face. You know what I mean? That's a big slap in the face. At least let us know, your streamers, your partners, or people that are going to have to find a job somewhere else. Like, let us know. Give us a heads up kind of thing. That to me was a big slap in the face and pretty disrespectful to us. You know, let us know before we find out from our viewers and stuff. They're like, yo, man, yo, Mixer's shutting the door. And you're like, what are you talking about, man? And sure enough, it was true. So that was a big kind of slap in the face, as well, which, you know, it kind of sucked. But, enough about that. I want to talk about the things that, you know, Twitch does right. Actually, before I get out of that, before I get off of Mixer, I want to say another thing too, was, they had this thing called Mixer Matchups, which was kind of cool. When I started streaming, I played a game called Paladins, which they did that. So basically what it is, if you're a streamer and you're streaming Paladins, you could be in this tournament to win like 5,000 embers, which is like bits, and all you have to do is play. And it was really cool. So if you're in the top 50, you'd get something like, you know, 2,000 bits or something like that. I don't remember what it was. But it was just fun. It was really neat to meet other streamers that play the same game as you. You know, it was really neat. And they had another thing called Hype Zone, which was cool at first, but then it really, you know, didn't do much. So it was basically, it's called Hype Zone. So they had something for Fortnite, PUBG, Call of Duty, maybe Apex. I don't remember the games. There was like four or five games, like BR games, okay? And basically, if you're about to win, if you're like winning or something like that, I don't know how they knew. I don't know the algorithms. I don't know algorithms, but basically, if you're close to winning, if you're like final three or something, they can actually host you. It's called the Hype Zone. And what it is, it's just like a lot of people that they'll go in the Hype Zone stream, and it'll just automatically host you, your channel. And all of a sudden you can have, if you're playing like Fortnite or something, at one point you get like 1,000 viewers. Just like that. Boom, boom. They host you if you're in like the final three, and then it's like, oh, all of a sudden you have 1,000 viewers in your stream. You could go from nothing to 1,000. That was really cool. But by the end of it, I mean, they just got rid of all that, and you'd get maybe like 50 viewers, 100 viewers maybe, which is not small. It's still good. But what I'm saying is it went from, you know, over 1,000 to like maybe 50. So it really died down near the end of the career of Mixer. But anyway, yeah, so let's get into Facebook gaming a little bit. So when we shut the doors, or Mixer shut the doors, I said we, but Mixer, Facebook gaming came in. Okay. I don't know if they got sold. I don't know the details. Not my problem. Not my business. Don't care. But basically Facebook gaming was trying to absorb all of the Mixer partners. Okay. And I'll be straight with you. They offered us, I think it was like $3,000, something like that, of the partners to go over there. So you had to stream for so many, I don't remember the details, but you had to stream for so long and this and that. And you know, Facebook Gaming, they have this guy called Stone Mountain. Now, this guy's a great streamer. Like, do not get me wrong. This guy is very good at what he does. He's phenomenal. But let me tell you, that is their baby. Okay. So they're going to push Stone Mountain. They're that's their guy, which I get it. That's business. Okay. If someone's bringing in viewership, you push them a little bit more, right? The problem with that is, if you're not Stone Mountain, who are you? You're nothing there. Okay. Now there's going to be people going to say, well, you know, I'm on Facebook, and I get it. Yes. He's not the only person. There's other very good streamers there too. But even when they were trying to talk to us, that was their pitch. Oh, Stone Mountain. They're pitching Stone Mountain to us, okay? Now, they tried to make this deal sound really good. And listen, again, nothing against Facebook Gaming. Zero disrespect towards anybody that goes there. Good for you. I'm happy you're there. You're doing well or whatever. That's great. But I could see the red flags. I could see the red flags just from that meeting. And it was like, no, not a chance, not doing it. And now, the contract thing was something like 3 months. I don't know the details. Not my problem. Not my business. Something like 3 months. And I called it, and I called it. I told my friends that were going to Facebook, I said, listen, man, this is a 3-month contract, and it's going to look beautiful for 3 months. Once that 3 months is up, man, they're going to drop you. They need you for 3 months. They're going to get you in there. So you put your time, your effort, you bring your community there. And then once your 3 months is up, they're going to drop you. And guess what happened? That 3 months is up, and you see all these Facebook gamer streamers, whatever you want to call it, gamer. I don't know what it's called. Facebook gaming, is that what it's called? Streamers. They're like, yo, what's going on? My algorithms are at zero now, and this and that. And they all, now, not all of them, some of them came to back to Twitch. The problem is you dropped your community to go to Facebook Gaming. And a lot of the community said, you know what? I don't want to go to Facebook Gaming. I'm just going to go to Twitch with everybody else. Because that's what happened. A lot of the streamers got split. Some went to Trovo. Some went to Facebook. Some went to Twitch. Some went to YouTube. Whatever it is, okay? Some went to whatever. Who cares? Whatever you want to do. But that's the problem now. So now the problem is you went to Facebook. A lot of your community said, yeah, you know what? That's not my thing. I'm going to go to Twitch because, you know, a lot of my other streamer friends are going there. And now they don't have that connection with you anymore. They've made other friends. They've met other communities. They're part of other communities now. And you're on Facebook. And then you come to Twitch like, hey, guys, I'm back. And it's like, oh, awesome. Well, you know, I kind of have my friends over here now. You know what I mean? I've made a lot of friends kind of thing. And you're in a different circle or something. You know what it is? And a lot of these people that went over to Facebook Gaming are struggling now with their streams. And not everybody. Listen, this is not good. I'm not trying to paint everybody with one brush. Just a lot of my friends that I know. And hey, some of them are killing it on Facebook, which is great. But again, for me personally, and this is not a shout out to anybody over there. You know, big shout out to my friends that are over there. And I'm glad you're killing it. I'm glad you're doing well. I'm just talking about the ones that have talked to me about their experiences that happened to be negative. And they told me the same things. They said, yo, man, listen, if you're not playing Call of Duty, you're not getting the viewership. If you're trying to play, you know, a game that you just have fun with, you're not going to get those algorithms that are going to bring, you know, viewers to your stream. It's just, that's not how it works. If you're playing Call of Duty, they're going to push the viewers to you or whatever. You know, once the 3 months is up, they saw all their stats drop. Hey, man, that's the nature of the beast, man. It's a 3-month contract. Once it's done, man, they got what they needed from you. And that's the problem, is they got what they needed from you. They got your community and your friends to come on over. And then now they're in Facebook. You know what I mean? So, you know, I tried to help some of my friends and I tried to give them the advice, but you can only say so much. And you don't want to just be disrespectful, because that's their, just like for me, when I was on Mixer, you don't want to hear people shitting on your brand and your site, because you have pride. You're proud to be there. I was proud to be a part of Mixer. I loved it. I believed in it. And again, I thought it was amazing. The people we met there were phenomenal. But this is what I'm trying to get at with this story is, I would never make that decision again to go to a, you know, I don't want to say smaller site, because that's not the right way to say it, but Twitch is the site. Okay, when you're look, when you think of a stream, you think of Twitch. You know, oh, a streamer, Twitch. That's what you think of. You don't think of Mixer. You don't think of Trovo. You don't think of Facebook Gaming. You don't think of Glimmer. You don't think of these sites. When someone says they're a streamer, you immediately think of Twitch. And trust me, I know from experience when I was on Mixer and people would ask me again, what's your job? I say I'm a streamer, and they say, oh yeah, man, my buddy streams on Twitch too or whatever. Immediately, everybody's mindset goes to Twitch. So it's like, you know, if you're buying a sandwich, you're not going to go to an ice cream shop, right? You're going to go to a place that sells sandwiches. And that's what I did. A site that streams, that's what I do for a living. I'm going to go to the site that streams, the main streaming platform, and that's Twitch. As hard as it could be, I think it's the right choice. And they have a lot of, you know, connections and stuff. And I think it's the spot. For me personally, I wouldn't put my eggs in Trovo or in Glamesh or something like that. Nothing against anybody that does that. Like, please, okay? But personally, I made that decision before to go to Mixer, and it didn't work out. I wouldn't want to go and try my luck at another site like this or like DLive or something, you know? And then, you know, it doesn't work out again. And then you got to kind of, okay, guys, now we're going here. And, you know, just I'm not into that, you know? So for me, it's like I like stability. I don't like change. I like stability. And for me, Twitch is the spot. I don't think it's going anywhere anytime soon. It's massive. And, you know, I think it's the place to be as a streamer. Now, which brings me to all like my next points and stuff with Twitch, with hype trains and stuff. That stuff is cool, man. We didn't have that stuff on Mixer. Something as cool as a hype train, getting your community involved. The first time I saw, actually, funny story. My very first hype train on Twitch, I wasn't even streaming. I was still streaming on Mixer, and it was phenomenal. So I'm doing one of my last streams on Mixer. I kind of tell everyone, oh, we're moving over to Twitch now, and you know, doing that. And then all of a sudden, so the community over from Mixer start following me over on Twitch, and they start dropping bits. I'm not even live on Twitch, okay? I'm live on Mixer, and they start dropping bits and stuff. And all of a sudden, there's a train. I'm like, what is that? What is it? What's a hype train? I don't even know what that is. And it was really, really, really cool. So we had our first hype train on Twitch. Didn't even stream there yet. Was never live, which was really, really awesome. So that was really cool. So shout out to all you guys. You know who you are. That made that possible. That was really cool. For sure. So that was neat, man. I like that kind of stuff. You know what I mean? I don't know. That was cool. So anyway, before I start rambling on and on and on, all that stuff. I think for me personally with Mixer, you know, and actually, before I end that, I want to say the reason why I even started streaming, if we want to get into that a little bit, and why I picked Mixer. That's what people ask, why did you pick Mixer? Like, why Mixer over Twitch or anywhere else, right? Like, why Mixer? Why? Great question. Why Mixer? Because here's the thing. I was a construction worker for 20 years, okay? It's all I ever knew. I was 15 years old when I started construction. It's all I ever knew. Okay, I don't know technology. I still don't even know technology. This is my job now. I kind of felt it happened by accident. So I used to do a thing called archery tag. Okay, so it's like paintballing with bow and arrows, and super fun game. If you have a spot by your place, I highly recommend you go. It can be very dangerous, but it's fun. All right. So anyway, I'm doing archery tag and I dislocate my shoulder, just doing my thing. And I have to get surgery. Now, I'm Canadian, so in Canada, healthcare is free, but the downfall is you gotta wait, you know, it could be a year just to see a surgeon. That's what happened to me. So it's like, okay, well, I have a year, I can't work, I can't do construction with a busted up shoulder. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna just, you know, throw on my and that was the thing, right? I didn't have a pro setup. I didn't have this big setup for streaming. So what I did was I just said, hey, I'll plug in my Xbox and blah, 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 here we go. And you can just stream like that. I use my my Xbox Kinect for my face cam, like just like that. Right. And anyway, so that was it. So I'm streaming. My whole thought process was, yo, man, I'm going to be able to stream for a year. I'll make a friend or two playing, you know, Call of Duty or Apex or Destiny, whatever game I want to play. It doesn't really matter. And I'll make a few cool friends like that. And then, you know, I'll go back to work and see you later. Well, you know, we started building a little bit of momentum and a community starts building in. And it was just things were kind of moving. And then it's like, okay, well, I go see the surgeon. Now my year is up. Now I go to see my surgeon. And the surgeon basically says, hey, listen, man, you know, there's nothing we can do. That shoulder, it's kind of healed, all messed up. We could do the surgery. We might make more damage. We might not fix it at all. It's not worth it. It's a big intrusive surgery. Not really worth it. So I said, you know what? Well, hey, man, I mean, I got no choice. Luckily, I started streaming. So I wasn't just kind of like at that moment, like, oh, man, I got to start doing something. So we already had kind of a community built in already at that point. So that was it. It's like, all right, well, this is it. This is what we're doing. We're going to be a full-time streamer. And honestly, man, this is a dream I've had since I was a kid. When I was growing up, we didn't have, you know, Twitch or streaming or anything like that. You know, we had a normal Nintendo, a Nintendo 64, a Super Nintendo, and it was everybody's dream, okay, to one day play video games. And I say play video games for a living. I don't play video games for a living. I entertain for a living. The video games are just kind of there in the background, but I entertain for a living. That's what I do. But that was the dream as a kid, you know, yo, playing video games for a living, how cool would that be? And that's where we are, where we're at, man. Now, it's not the easiest job. You know, a lot of people suffer from, you know, mental health and stuff through streaming. It is very, very tough because you're at the mercy of everybody. You're at the mercy of everything. There are things in your control, but there's a lot of things that aren't in your control. And, you know, a lot of people, they doubt themselves and they get in their own heads and, you know, it can be very taxing on you as a person, for sure. So that's definitely something, to be aware of. Anyway, before I get too off track, cause this is supposed to be about Mixer and Twitch, and I could just ramble on and on and on. But, anyway, before I close it up, I do want to say, Mixer was a great site, okay? I absolutely loved it. I got nothing bad to say about it other than the fact that they kind of did, you know, they were disrespectful how they let us go. But it was a phenomenal site. The community was amazing. I have nothing bad to say about it in that regards, other than the fact that you could tell they were very confused with a lot of things, okay? Actually, before I got one more thing I want to say too, I want to add into here. There was a big problem, okay? So, again, the viewerships was a big problem. And they used to have, like, 24/7 channels where you could just go in and farm sparks, right? I talked about sparks and stuff, right? And you could go in and you could farm sparks all day, 24/7. You leave your computer on, you just farm it all day. There was this one channel, man. It was actually pretty cool, man. It was, like, Gandalf, and it was, like, this song. I don't know, man. It was a song playing. It was really cool, man. And you could just sit there all day and farm sparks. Or you could just, you know, leave your friends' tabs up for your friends and stuff, you know, kind of thing. But anyway, a lot of people complained that, yo, we got to get rid of these 24/7 channels. Now, the problem is those channels are helping there's pros and cons to it, okay? There's positives and negatives. The positives are that the site has more concurrent viewers when they're there. Yes, they're just idle. They could be bots. I don't know. They're idle accounts, idle whatever. Yeah, sure, they're not there. But in a game of numbers, it adds more numbers to the site. And for the longest time, the partners and people are complaining, oh, they're taking our viewers, get rid of them, blah, 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 blah. And you could tell that Mixer was always fighting back, like, you know, oh, soon, soon, soon. You could tell they didn't want to do it because it's almost like they knew this is going to be very bad for our numbers. And eventually they bit and they said, okay, we're getting rid of 24/7 channels. And they did. And you saw the numbers drop. And that, to me, I mean, that's not the beginning of the end, but it definitely didn't help. You know what I mean? It definitely, definitely, definitely didn't help. And then, you know, not long after, man, it's like, see you later. Now, I remember there was a stat that came out, I don't know if it was like a month or two. It was very close to the end where it showed the growth of all the platforms from, you know, YouTube and Twitch and Mixer. I don't know, whatever else was there. DLive. I don't know what was there. Man, because there was COVID. COVID was happening. So a lot of people were still home. Or a lot of people, it was like the beginning of COVID and people were home. And what happens is every site was like 50% growth, 30% growth. And then there was Mixer, 2%. 2%. And you could see right there, that was the start. That was the problem. That was a problem. If you have sites that are 50% increase in volume, and then you have Mixer with like 2%, and that's when they blamed their initial blame was, oh, well, we got rid of the 24/7 channels. Don't worry about it. Well, you know, that was a sure sign that things were coming, you know? But anyway, again, I have nothing bad to say about Mixer other than the few, you know, obviously the way they let us go. I loved the community. I loved the platform. I loved the things they had. I loved their ideas. I loved everything about it. The small town feel. I absolutely loved it. But in the same breath, I will say, I think Twitch is a way better platform. Yes, it's missing a few of the key things I think worked for Mixer, but you know what? It's Twitch. It's obviously doing something right if it's, you know, succeeding the way it is. So Twitch is the platform, okay? I know people don't want to hear it. I know people are going to say, you know, oh, Trovo, go Trovo. Listen, I feel you. I was like that with Mixer. You know, but again, If you're on there has to be someone that's killing it on Trovo. There has to be someone that's killing it on Glamesh. There are going to be streamers that are going to absolutely blow it out of the water. So I'm not trying to paint everything with one brush. But yo, I'm telling you, man, Twitch is the spot. And I'm loving it. I'm so thankful for being here on Twitch. And again, guys, I will have my links below, everything you can follow and stuff, but it's gonna be twitch.tv/CaponeGaming. And yo, man, you want to come by the site. Trust me on that, man. We have a really good community, really good vibes, positive vibes. We don't put up with stuff. We don't, you know, we just have a good time. That's what it's about, man. I promise I'll make you laugh, man. We'll entertain you. I promise. So anyway, guys, if you're still watching, we're 40 minutes in. This will be a quick 5-minute video, man. I'm 40 minutes in, rambling. If you're still here, fam, thank you for watching to the end. And I really hope to see you in the stream and get to know the community and stuff. We do a lot of fun games, and we're always very chat-oriented and community-oriented. So if that's something you're interested in, come on by. And just let me know. Hey, man, I saw you from that. I watched your video and I enjoyed it or whatever. Maybe you didn't like it. You know what I mean? Maybe you got a bone to pick with me. Well, hey, come by. Let me know. All right, guys. Much love. I'm out of here. Peace.